me baladais sur l'avenue, le cœur ouvert à l'inconnu. J'avais envie de dire bonjour à n'importe qui, et ce fut toi. Je t'ai dit n'importe quoi, il suffisait de te parler pour t'apprivoiser.
Oh, Champs-Élysées.
Oh, hey, Emin. What a lovely shirt you're wearing.
Oh, thank you, honey. Actually, I was feeling a little blue today. I thought that this shirt would match my mood.
Oh, what a perfect choice. But tell me, did you know that the same choice was actually made by a man who walked on this very land almost 300 years ago?
Are you talking about?
I know you know it. Alexander Roslin! Ah, you understand Leblibi before I say Leb.
Oh, yeah. Oh, my dearest Roslin.
You know he was originally born in Sweden, right?
Yeah, but he lived in Paris during most of the times that he painted. At those times, fashion design was very widely practiced in Paris.
Yes, this man was no fashion designer, but he was like a mirror. His paintings were mostly portraits, and their most prominent trait...
Clothing!
Roslin's take on clothing actually displayed the domination of rationalism over emotionalism, and it symbolizes the oppression of emotions in his paintings.
Take this one for instance, a portrait by Roslin of an unknown woman. Unknown, but certainly a part of the aristocracy.
The fabrics that were used, silks, satins, velvets, linen, heavy embroidery and lace, lots and lots of lace, are very expensive, displaying her class. Rationalism was ingrained in the aristocracy's power and wealth. Their emotions, on the other hand, were oppressed, as seen from the lady's face, almost as if they're set in the background. The emotion that is actually visible is self-confidence. Her body language, on the other hand, is very strong, not displaying any emotion, as a symbol of her steadiness.
But there's more to it. We see here that the oppressed emotions that you've talked about are actually being depicted through color of clothing, just like your jacket.
You know there is a Turkish saying, "Ay aynen öyle lafı ağzımdan aldın." I'm shocked. Here, blue symbolizes the sadness and the loneliness brought by the high reputation of the subject. It's almost as if emotions have reached a dead end while trying to get to the face. That's why they instead emerge as the colors of clothing.
And it wasn't only women that he depicted. Sometimes, color was used as an object of its own.
For example, this man's golden clothing is mesmerizing. Fame, charm, contentness of power. This time, even color became a part of rationalism.
But that's not what I'm talking about. Look at the palette. Many colors I see. It's almost as if the man is trying to convey his inner feelings to the painting that he's painting within a painting.
Ah, yes. Now I understand. Oh la la. Look at the man he painted. Oh my god, he's wearing white. It's almost as if he has given up on that fame you have talked about for the sake of pure emotions.
Yes, precisely. And this is just like another example of those inner emotions being oppressed by his external look that he's trying to display to the society.
And the fine reflection of the era's pressure regarding socioeconomic class.
Yes. Needless to say, all the rich fabric employed in French fashion houses during the Rococo era was quite costly.
And yet, not all of Roslin's subjects were so oppressed by the rationalism of their status. Let's look at Lady with the View.
Surprisingly, the subject of this painting is not a prominent aristocrat, but it's Roslin's own wife, Marie-Suzanne Durost.
With a shocking departure from his other paintings, Roslin's portrayal of her wife does not include any glorious bright colors of clothing or any oppressed emotions.
On the very contrary, look at the black that she has herself wrapped around with. It's almost as if it's shutting out her need to display such power and worth like the previous one, displaying her confidence.
Exactly. She bears no concern of displaying her power, a confidence probably instilled by the fact that painters like Roslin could pretty much name his own price for their aristocratic customers.
Yeah, unlike the aristocrats in the previous paintings, Roslin required no show of power to reach prominency. His art took care of that for him.
In the absence of such concerns, Marie's face is full of compassion, a face of woman sharing a lovely look with her dear husband.
This simplicity in clothing is actually a big hint to the place of Alexander Roslin in art history.
Oh yes. My dearest Roslin was a real Rococo artist indeed. But some of his later works in fact served as a bridge to Neoclassicism.
Neoclassicism? Let's talk about that!
Okay, but get ready for surprises. You're about to see a very different clothing style from the Rococo period.
Spoiler alert!
We've already seen that in early Rococo, rationalism dominated the paintings, casting emotionalism out. Now, for our second set of paintings, this time of Neoclassicism, let's look at Henri Fuseli, a Swiss painter.
Oh yes! Fuseli lived in a time period that was more or less same as Alexander Roslin, making him a fine choice for our comparison.
More importantly, his choice of clothing was also prominent in his paintings, but from a different approach.
Which represents the evolution of clothing from Rococo into Neoclassicism.
Oh la la!
Let's have a look!
Unlike Roslin, Fuseli's choice of clothing was incredibly simple, bearing almost no detail in fabric or word.
It's almost as if all these emotions that were oppressed during the Rococo period have decided to flourish once again.
Yes, through the simplicity of the subject's garments, conveyed through the neutrality of the color white, Fuseli makes way for his viewers to notice other details that convey emotion.
Such as body language! Magnificent! For example, in this painting, we see the woman's face without seeing her face. Her depressed face is apparent without even looking at it.
Oh yes, the artist is no longer afraid to express feelings directly. He is free from any constraints of symbol or financial oppressions.
Oh mon dieu, what a fabulous change.
Yes. From the static, Fuseli presents us with the most dynamic of emotions.
In this one, called the Italian Count, Fuseli does use color in the grieved man looking at his wife.
Yes, red, the color of death.
And of love.
But still, the details are much less than those of Roslin and Rococo. You can't even understand what the fabric is, which was never the case for Rococo.
The woman's clothing, on the other hand, is not a white of neutrality like the previous one, but a white of purity.
Yes. Once again, the color of clothing helps us understand the situations, while their simplicity allows us to understand emotions from the stances of two characters.
Let's look at another example with similar attributes, but this one is my favorite.
This one is a special
painting. The white is here again, but this time, instead of conveying emotion, it conveys contrast.
Do you mean contrast with the reddish color of the demon and the black color of the horse?
Perfecto! The Nightmare is one of the most famous paintings of Fuseli, known for its shockingly expressive emotions.
Oui! The canvas seems to portray simultaneously a dreaming woman and the content of her nightmare. The contrast that you have talked about, established through the clothings, is in fact a borderline of that.
I am frightened when I look at this painting.
Exactly as Fuseli has intended, probably. This painting is a bold demonstration of fear, perhaps one of the strongest emotions.
Yes, the previous oppression of emotionalism by rationalism has ceased completely and is now replaced by an outmost roar of emotionalism in its purest form.
You're right. The clash between emotionalism and rationalism may go on for centuries, but at least for the time of Neoclassicism, and at least for Henri Fuseli, emotionalism appears to have won the upper ground.
This was a very lovely and rewarding conversation, my dear Emma. But now that I think about it, how did we start this discussion?
From my shirt, remember? I was feeling blue. Well, now I don't.
Wow, you really completed your transition into a Neoclassicist state.
Don't be fooled by the history of art, Emin Jim. The theme of clothing is still prominent in this very day, both in art and in my life.